Hello, everyone. I'm Dr. Wen. Here is the question. We want to factor x to the power 4 plus x to the power 3 minus 4x squared plus x plus 1. This is a normal question. So here, we are going to introduce this in two different methods to discuss to solve this question in two different ways. First method, we use the tip. This is a general polynomial, how to find its root. We know the result, the product of all roots for this polynomial, the left-hand side, equal to zero, equals a zero over a n times negative one to the power n. N is what? The degree of the polynomial. A zero, that's constant term. A n is the leading constant. So here we have this result. Product of all roots equal to this. Back to our question. If we want to use the long division or grouping method, we need to know at least one root. So here we are trying to find a one root, use this tip. So look at this here, our question. We have our n is 4 and a 0, a 4 is 1. So here product of all roots equals 1 over 1. It's 1 over 1, and a negative to the power 4, which is positive 4. So we know that all integer roots, the product of all integer roots equal to 1. So that means x equals 1 is a possible root. Here we only say it's a possible. We're not sure. Root for this one. That means that's a zero for this polynomial. By checking, x equals 1 is a root. How to check it? Replace x by 1 if this is equal to 0. Plug in here, 1, 1, negative 4, 1, 1. So here it is 0. So here x equals 1 is a root. Now we are ready to use long division. If we use long division, we can easily affect x minus 1 out. Then this is the quotient. That's x to the power 3 plus 2x squared minus 2x minus 1. So here, can we continue to factor this? We can repeat the same idea. This is the constants, negative 1, and here's 1. So we can use the same idea. Find x equals 1 is a root. Plug in, you can check it. That's equal to 0. So we can factor this. As this one, x minus 1. Times x squared plus 3x plus 1. So what is this? This is this part. It's the second part of our original polynomial. Original polynomial, we already factor x1 out. So we factor another one from the second part. Put them together. You have x minus 1 squared. Here's 1, here's 1. So here the final result for x to the power 4 plus x to the power 3 minus 4x squared plus x plus 1 equals x minus 1 squared times x squared plus 3x plus 1. This is for the first method. Let's look the second method. We call the unusual. So here, that's a polynomial. First of all, we factor 1x squared out for every term here. For x squared, you have x squared inside remaining part for x to the power 4. For x to the power 3, you have x here. For this one, you have a negative 4 here. For this one, you don't have enough x squared here. You factor 1 out, you have to divide by x. So here, that's 1 over x squared. If you still have a question about this part, you can go back to check it. X squared times 1 over x squared is 1. X squared times 1 over x is x. So this is 2. Now, look at this step. What are we doing? We are trying to use the perfect square method, completing this square. So here, group x squared and 1 over x squared, and put 2 here. And here, x plus 1 over x is here. And where comes the negative 6? Negative 6, you already took 2 here. 2 plus negative 6 is negative 4. Or you can think of this way. Negative 4, you add 2 here, you have to minus 2. Minus 2 minus 4 is minus 6. Now rewrite this as this one. First part is x plus 1 over x squared, this part. We can check it. So x plus 1 over x squared equals x squared here. And the 2 times first term and the second term, 2 times x, 1 over x cancel each other. You have 2 here. And the last term, the second term squared is 1 over x squared. It's true. So here, what can you see now? Here's x plus 1 over x, then square, plus x plus 1 over x, minus 6. If you don't see this, continue. We let this x plus 1 over x as a new variable. That's y. Replace x plus 1 over x by y. Then we have here x squared here. This is y squared plus y. Y squared plus y minus 6. So for this part, the second part, y squared plus y minus 6, we can easily to factor this part. At least you have a quadratic formula to use. We'll find y plus 3, y minus 3. So that's this part. So what is y? We define x plus 1 over x. Replace y back by x plus 1 over x. Plug in here. So we want to get rid of the denominator x. So here you have x squared outside. X squared equals x times x. Give 1x to this factor. Give another x to the second factor. So x times x is x squared. X times 1 over x is 1. X times 3, that's 3x. You have another x here. X times x is x squared. X times 1 over x is 1. X times negative 2 is negative 2x. So here, consider this. Here. What is this? This is a perfect square, complete square. That's x minus 1 squared. Second part, we cannot go further to factor this. So this is the final answer. This is the answer for the given polynomial. X to the power 4 plus x to the power 3 minus 4x squared plus x plus 1 equals x minus 1 squared times x squared plus 3x plus 1. That's all. Thanks for watching and see you next time.